बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। प्यारे बच्चों, अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। 11th क्लास गोडुक लेक्चर चु बायोलॉजी गोडुक चैप्टर दैट इज डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म्स। डाइवर्सिटी का छ वन अनिस डाइवर्सिटी गो नंबर एंड टाइप्स ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म्स on this planet Earth. That means different types of organisms which range from microorganisms, fungi, insects, plants, and most advanced group that is animals. Asani variation chwananis biodiversity. Bio means living, diversity means diversity of living organisms. Is a jyada diversity aasi tu ch jyada evolution gasnuk chance aasan ti ch nay nay types banan yuta variation kam aasi ti ch nay nay types chance kam aasan. That's why as karo shuru diversity pati as a word means biodiversity, bio diversity. It's made up of two words, that is bio. Bio means life or living organisms. Living organisms. And second is diversity. Diversity means variety. Roughly estimated that there are 1.7 to 1.8 million organisms, million species of living organisms are known to science. They are described and are named also by different biologists of the world. Out of 1.7 to 1.8 million species, 1.25 million species are animals. Million species belongs to animals. And 0.55 million species belong to plants. And scientists believe that the number of species that is present in the world, it may be ranged from ranges between 5 to 30 million. Since there are huge number of organisms in this planet Earth, and it is not possible to study each and every organism at individual level. We can't study each and every organism at individual level. Therefore, it is need of the hour to evolve a system which first identify, then give name, naming, identification, naming, and then classify these organisms in different groups on the basis of their similarities and relationships. On the basis of their similarities and relationships. And this system is evolved in the form of a new branch of biology that's called as taxonomy. T-A-X-O-N-O-M-Y. Taxonomy is a branch of biology. It is that branch of biology that deals with the study of three important components. That deals with the study of three important parameters. Number one, first is identification. First, living organisms are identified with the help of identification keys, floras, monographs, or herbarium sheets, etc. Second, you have nomenclature. It is a system of giving proper and scientific names to these living organisms. And third one is, that is classification. Classification. Then these organisms are arranged in a particular system of classification. They are arranged in a proper and beautiful system of classification. The word taxonomy was first proposed by A.P. de Candolle. In 1813, however, the actual foundation study, stone for taxonomy was laid by Carlos Linnaeus. It was Carlos Linnaeus, who is remembered as father of taxonomy and systematics. Taxonomy as a word means, is a Greek word. It is a Greek word, taxis, T-A-X-I-S. Taxis means arrangement. It's a Greek word, taxis, which means arrangement, and nomi. Second word, nomi. Nomi means law. It's the law of arrangement of living organisms into different groups, into different categories. Then there are some taxonomic categories by which we can classify a particular organism in a particular category. And this taxonomic hierarchy, taxonomic grouping, or taxonomic hierarchy that's also proposed by Carlos Linnaeus. That's why we also call as Linnaean hierarchy. Linnaean hierarchy. With the help of taxonomic hierarchy, we can arrange different living organisms in different taxonomic categories. Different taxonomic categories. On the basis of their relative similarities. On the basis of their relative similarities or relative dimensions. And there are seven obligate taxonomic categories which can be right as there are seven taxonomic categories which are as follows. First category is kingdom. First category is kingdom, which form the top of taxonomic hierarchy. It form the apex or it form the top of taxonomic hierarchy. It is followed by division. It is followed by division in case of plants or phylum or phyla. Phyla in case of animals. It is followed by another category, that is class. Class followed by another category, that is order. Order is followed by another category, that is family. That is family. It is followed by another category, that is genus. And last one at the base of taxonomic hierarchy is the species. Species form the base of taxonomic hierarchy, while as the kingdom form the top of taxonomic hierarchy. That's why species is considered to be basic unit of classification. It is considered to be as basic unit of classification. And in case of species, it is an assemblage of individuals, group of individuals having fundamental similarities. For example, all the human beings belong to the same species because they show basic similarities, because they have fundamental similarities. Similarly, when number of species having sharing some common features, they are put together in a single genus. And when number of genera, they share certain common features, they were put in a single family. And when number of families, related families, they share certain characters which are common, we are put them in a single order. Similarly, when number of orders, group of orders, having related characters, they are put in a single class. And number of classes, group of classes, which share some common characteristics, they are put in a single division. And when number of divisions or phylas, they share some certain basic characters, they are put in a single kingdom. That means it forms a ladder-like structure. It forms a ladder-like structure like this. Wherein species is at the base of this ladder and kingdom is at the top of this ladder. When we go from kingdom to species, That means in a descending order, the number of similar, or you can say related characters goes on increasing. But when we go in ascending order from species on to kingdom, the number of related characters goes on decreasing, which means that if we move from kingdom onto species, we move towards increasing spasticity. But as we move from species onto kingdom, there is decrease in speed. We move towards decreasing spasticity. 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 That means, in case of species having number of individuals, they share number of similar characters. But as we go towards kingdom, the number of common characters goes on decreasing. For example, if we take the example of a plant having scientific name Malus domestica. It is a scientific name for your apple. In science, apple is called Malus domestica, wherein Malus is the generic name and domestica is the specific epithet, or you can say it's a species or specific epithet according to binomial nomenclature. If we arrange this plant according to taxonomic hierarchy, it is arranged like this: kingdom, plantae. It's followed by division, and division is angiospermy. Means apple is a flowering plant bearing flowers as well as fruits. Since seeds are covered in the fruits, that we call them as angiosperms, closed seed plants, or we can say enveloped seed plants. It is put in angiospermy division, and followed by division, it is class. It's having angiosperms are divided into two categories. One category having two cotyledons in seeds, we call them as dicotyledony, and second category having single cotyledon in their seeds called monocotyledony. And in this case, there are two cotyledons in a seed, that's why we put them in dicotyledony. It's followed by order. In case of apple, it belongs to order Rosales. It's followed by another one, that is family. is having the family of Rosaceae. Then genus, it is Malus. And last one is species, that is Domestica. That means it's the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. I've already told you that there are seven categories in the taxonomic hierarchy. And in case of apple, the classification is like this. And with the help of these taxonomic categories, we can classify any living organisms on the basis of this pattern. With this, we complete taxonomic hierarchy. Inshallah, next time, we'll come with the next topic. Till then, good day. Have a good night. Inshallah.